This is Ben from the Be a Photographer channel, and today I want to talk to you about color grading. See, teal and orange look really nice and are very often used. Even green and pink could work for a color grade, but don't use something like pink and blue. There's no contrast in that, and to understand a good color grade, all we have to do is take a look at a simple color wheel. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to visually color grade an image using the color balance tool in Capture One Pro 20. As you can see, these three images looked pretty decent straight out of the camera, but using just the color balance and some slight exposure adjustments, we got a really nice color grade in just a matter of seconds. And at the end of the video, I'll also show you how you can apply these color grades from one image to another in just a matter of seconds, and then control the strength by using a layer mask and the opacity slider. So let's get started with this image of the Kindle, and there are just three main things you need to understand about the color balance tool, which is found here in the color balance section. Firstly, there are four main color wheels. You might think there are only three because there's the three-way section here, and then shadow, midtone, highlight, that makes three. But you also have your master, and that creates a fourth. Second, you always want to do your color grade on a layer mask. So we're gonna start by pressing new filled layer, and calling this color grade, and you have to understand how the color balance wheels work. So let's take a look at the highlight wheel here, and on the right side, we'll start with the luminance adjuster. As you can expect, with the luminance adjuster on the right side, as you slide down, it brings the highlights down in the image, so you can see the clouds are being controlled. I can either blow them out or bring them down by using the right side. Then we have our color selector in the middle, so if I want to give them more of a yellow in the clouds, I could do that. Or if I want to go towards the blues, I can move this around as well. And on the left side, we have the saturation level control. So as you can see on the outside edge of the circle, the saturation is very strong. And if I want to minutely control just the saturation level, I can slide here on the left side, and you can see that moves dynamically. If we ever want to reset it, we can just double tap in the circle and it resets. On this image, let's say I want to make the sky a little bit more orange, bring a little bit of fire into it. So I'm going to bring that down here and bring more detail into the clouds by bringing down the exposure. And what I want to do is add the opposite color tones on the shadows. So if the highlights are more in the orange and red, then we want to go blue in the shadows. And if you take a look at a sunset, those are the complementary contrasting colors, and it looks really nice. So we're going to add some blue in the shadows here. And if I want to add more contrast, I can bring the shadows down as well and bring the strength down. This color grade was very easy to do, super quick, and you can see it adds a lot of drama to the image. But I think it's way too strong and intense, and personally it's not my style. Since we did this on a layer mask, what we can do is grab the opacity and slide to the left to make it weaker, or slide to the right to make it stronger. That way we don't have to go in and minutely adjust the shadows level and the highlights level. And let's say we have our color grade just about where we want it, but I want to warm up the entire thing. Now, instead of moving the three wheels here in the shadows, midtones, and highlights, I can simply grab the master wheel and move towards a warmer tone right about there, and again, control the saturation on the left side. Quickly, we can take a look at our before, our after, tone down the color grade just a little bit, and that is how we edit in just a matter of seconds. Keep in mind the color wheel when you're using this tool. You want to add contrasting or complementary colors. You can see if you have green, you'd want to go with a purple rose type color. If you have yellow, you want to go with a purplish blue. And if you have red, you want to go with a lighter blue or teal. Very easy to understand, and just Google color wheel whenever you need something for reference. Now let's take a look at how we can apply this to another image. It's very simple. Once you have your color grade done, you simply hit copy up here in the top right, go to an image of your choice, and hit the apply button right next to it. Now you can see that color grade that we had on the first image of Kayla is brought to this one, and again with the opacity slider, I can make it a little bit stronger, or I can weaken the effect, and if I wanted to, I still have complete control over the three-way color balance here, so I can adjust as needed per image. I hope you learned something new in this tutorial. If you did, please leave a comment below, give it a thumbs up, I hope you subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.